Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like first to read some extracts from ICOMOS evaluation. Quote, ICOMOS considered that the heart of historic Jeddah could be seen as a response to the wealth generated by the Indian Ocean trade that reflects the fusion of diverse cultural strands from this mercantile activity with the local Red Sea culture, end quote. Then, quote, the nominated area may have the capacity to be seen as an outstanding reflection of the way Jeddah developed at the end of the 19th century as a result of the wealth generated by the expanded trade resulting from the opening of the Suez Canal, unquote. Again, quote, ICOMOS considered that the city is directly and tangibly associated with the way the Hajj was conducted over a period of several hundred years, unquote. When we read this, the only conclusion we can draw is that the nominated property meets effectively the criteria of OUV, particularly criterion 2, 4, and 6. ICOMOS further considers that the boundaries of the nominated property and buffer zone are adequate, that the management system set out by the state party appears to be satisfactory, and that the protection is adequate since the new law was adopted. What is missing, says ICOMOS, is that the attributes that convey OUV should be more specifically defined and the management system be tested. ICOMOS recommends, hence, that the examination of the dossier by the committee be deferred. We can understand that the lack of conservation is the greatest challenge facing the property, and that the overall conservation of the nominated area, as in the case for other living cities, is a long-term project. But we cannot postpone the inscription of urban sites on the list until all constituents are there to guarantee the best conservation practices, including testing management system, which is deemed to be satisfactory. Conservation is a dynamic process that is never ended. A few years ago, the city of Naples, with the help of the European Union, launched a program grouping local experts with experts from ICOMOS, UNESCO, and ICROM in order to define more precisely the attributes of its historic center, which is inscribed on the World Heritage List, and develop a comprehensive conservation strategy addressed through the historic and urban landscape approach. Since the OUV of the property of Jeddah is recognized, since its boundaries are adequate, since its management system appears satisfactory, since its protection appears satisfactory, as stated in ICOMOS evaluation, we propose to inscribe historic Jeddah on the World Heritage List and ask the state party, with the cooperation of the World Heritage Center and ICOMOS, to launch a three-year program in order to push forward the definition of property attributes and develop a comprehensive strategy for the conservation of the property based on the historic urban landscape approach. Thank you.
Thank you, Lebanon. I now